moment to moment. Force. Speed. Innovation. A family of 100. Backed by a family of thousands. The most unique experience in college football. Their commitment complete. Challenges overcome. Greatness proven. Every season defined. Moment to moment.
This today. Nothing will match what you have with these people. The 11 guys out there going to battle. When you get your chance, on the field, on the sideline, in the huddle, do something about it. There's never a down off. You never let up, you never give up, you never give in. All sides of the ball, all cylinders, all game, every play. Snap to whistle, kick off to final. That's all I ask. But I will say this. Special teams.
Be special.
It all comes down to this.
A team with a singular mission. A mission shared by 60,000 fans. And a Harley riding duck. This is the stage against the Huskies. Against the Bruins. Against the Cardinal. And the Wildcats. This is Oregon game day, and there is no other place on earth like it. 694,
and they will get that and more as Masoli throws it deep. It is caught, touchdown.
688.
Garrett Blunt's throwing his hand. I don't think there was a whistle. Blunt goes into the end zone. Touchdown.
630 yards. That is the Oregon offense. Not just the best in the Pac-10 this year across the board. Scoring, total yards, rushing, and more. But among the best ever in Pac-10 history. Offensive coordinator Chip Kelly's offense brought innovation and success to a new level. The Ducks averaged 545 yards per game, including an incredible 280 yards per game, second best in all of college football behind Navy. Oregon's ground game was so dominant, two tailbacks rushed for more than 1,000 yards this season. First, Jeremiah Johnson. Then, LeGarrette Blount, 17 touchdowns, an Oregon single-season record.
Almost breaking free, LeGarrette Blount does break free. Run to the 50, run to the 40, to the 30, he's at the 20. Yeah, he is going to score! Touchdown, LeGarrette Blount!
And national headlines in how he did it.
Hands it off, left Blount's going to go right back. Oh, boy, jumps on the 15, got his feet in.
A 1-2 punch that proved unstoppable all season. But that's not where it ended behind this senior-laden, experienced, massive offensive line. If those two didn't have it, chances are Oregon quarterback Jeremiah Masoli did. Weaving his way and blowing through defenses for 718 yards and 10 touchdowns, becoming the all-time leading rusher at quarterback in Oregon history. Certainly, Oregon's incredible rushing attack was the envy of college football. But what made Oregon's offense virtually unstoppable was an entertaining balance highlighted by speed and style. With sophomore Masoli putting the ball in the air with growing efficiency, senior Terrence Scott emerged to lead the way. 751 yards, and 5 touchdowns through the air.
And a great touchdown!
Including 117 yards in a season-opening blowout win over Washington.
Scott, 20, Scott, 10, 5, touchdown, Scott!
93 in the Civil War over Oregon State. And another 125 as Oregon beat Oklahoma State in one of the best games of the year at the Holiday Bowl. And when teams stacked up on Scott, Jason Williams made them pay. Williams approached the all-time receiving record in Oregon history with 474 yards and 4 TDs this season. When they went to Williams, Jeffrey Mail made plays. When the focus went to Mail, the Ducks simply counted on the emergence of Chris Harper.
Harper, look at it go! Chris Harper, the 30! Harper, the 20! Wow!
And tight end Ed Dixon.
Touchdown, Ed Dixon!
Oregon's offense moved more than 4 miles this year. 6,303 yards. But what made it even more special is that it was in the moment. A clutch offense at its best in the biggest moments. Finishing games at the end. And showing the hearts of champions. A dagger dive play to put down Arizona in the final minutes. A 73-yard drive led by Masoli. And triggered by great play after great play when they had to have it. To beat Stanford in the final seconds. And over and over and over and over again against Oregon State. First Johnson with a signature run. And 23 more after the stiff arm. Then Masoli, with a 14-yard touchdown on the ground and in the air, hitting Terrence Scott in stride. Even when it looked like the Beavers had Oregon stopped, they still found a way to get to the end zone.
And Dixon is in the end zone, touchdown!
65 points in all. The most ever in a Civil War game to crush their rivals' dreams and to put themselves in the Holiday Bowl in one of the greatest wins in program history. Game after game, Oregon's offense came at their opponents in wave after wave. And 10 wins later, this incredible offense earned their nearly untouchable, incredible spot in history. That is, until next year. Defense. A convergence of speed and power, of quickness and agility, timely and tenacious. This Oregon defense, led by senior Nick Reed, who personified the entire unit, underestimated but undeterred, and in the end, defiant in victory and dominating in its execution. With 13 sacks, he became Oregon's all-time leader. With 20 tackles for loss, he led the Pac-10. With 5 fumble recoveries, he imposed his will on opposing linemen. Oregon head coach Mike Bellotti called the 6'2", 248-pound senior from Mission Viejo, pound for pound, the best defensive football player he's ever been around. Opposing quarterbacks were forced to agree. Causing havoc for opposing teams extended down Oregon's line. Achieving the first mission of Oregon's defensive philosophy, stopping the run. Reed, along with Rashawn Harris and Cole Linehan, with Will Tukuafu on the other end. The Duck defense finished second in the Pac-10 against the run. 5 times, the Oregon D held opponents under 100 yards rushing, including 63 against UCLA, 38 against Boise State, and a dream-crushing 89 against Oregon State on 31 carries. While the front seven was stacking up the run, the rest of the Duck D was waiting in the wings for what it meant. The football coming their way.
Intercepted by T.J. Ward. It's the ball, and he intercepts it. Oregon football.
Juniors Walter Thurman III and Jarius Bird pulled in 5 picks each to lead the Pac-10, each one at critical moments, and some ending in 6.
And this one is going to be picked off. Walter Thurman, touchdown.
And others on the D, like senior All-Pac-10 player Patrick Chung. making his presence known in every aspect of the game. The leader of this talented secondary, making plays at the most opportune time.
What intercepted! 20 and the 15 and the 10. Touchdown!
Setting the tone for each and every game. Oregon's defense also welcomed the emergence of new stars on their way to 10 wins. Junior T.J. Ward, a former walk-on, simply wanted it more than his opponents. 64 solo tackles, the most in the Pac-10. 101 total tackles, third in the league. And hits. Hits that have become his signature calling card. This Oregon D at its best, showing its collective toughness when it mattered the most. In the final moments against Arizona, causing turnovers while dismantling the Beavers.
The catch fumbles the football. Intercepted for the second time of the game. Touchdown. Lost the ball is free.
And in its penultimate moment.
Intercepted at the 5, at the 10, down the sideline of the 20.
Stifling the high-powered Oklahoma State offense on 8 out of 10 second-half possessions to deliver yet another Oregon Bowl championship, putting their signature stamp on this signature Oregon season.
Special teams.
Offense, defense, and Oregon's special teams, a third and equal cast made up of high-flying, hard-hitting determination. All great teams must be great across the board. And that was the case with the 2008 Oregon Ducks. Its best players making their presence known on special teams as well. Senior Patrick Chung, a double first-team All-Pac-10 player on defense and on special teams.
Taking 1 yard out of the end zone. Chung cuts across. There's a big hole. Chung has one guy to beat. Still going.
And to be great, all units must deliver at that critical moment. Mired in a slugfest against Purdue, it was special teams that brought Oregon alive and sparked an overtime victory. And then, in the Holiday Bowl, Walter Thurman changed the complexion of the game with a single play. While Bird and Thurman both finished third in the league on punt and kickoff returns respectively, the Ducks found steady improvement in all phases of special teams. Former walk-on kicker Morgan Flint finished the regular season without missing a single kick, including three critical field goals in the first half against Oregon State. Josh Cyree, Oregon's punter, third in the Pac-10's punting average, pinning opponents deep, kick after kick.
He moves one! Holy cow, did he get a foot into that?
And Matt Evenson, possibly the best ever on Oregon kickoffs. This special unit, complementing an incredible offense and sturdy defense, completing this team, and creating a culture of success and opportunity for those who want it the most, who desire to be the best in each and every aspect of the game. These brief moments are the inheritance of a select few. Oregon football. Innovative. Historic. An era of unprecedented success. Head coach Mike Bellotti leads the Ducks to their fourth 10-win season of his career. It's an experience of a lifetime. It's a unifying force. It's a collection of heart, determination, and desire. Oregon is more than an experience. It's every single minute of every single practice, every hit, every completion,